Hey everyone, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, we're gonna talk about Kittl's new feature. They're calling it Infinite Canvas. I'm calling it just adding new artboards to the page. So Canva has done this a long time where you can keep adding more and more artboards, and Affinity Designer does this too, and now Kittl does it. Previously, you could only do one design at a time, and this feature has been asked for a long, long time, ever since Kittl has come out. Why only one artboard? Now you can do multiple artboards. And I'm gonna show you exactly how to do it, the tips and tricks, all the shortcuts that you need, and how I'm gonna use it going forward. I think this will really help with print on demand, especially if you're doing two designs side by side, and if you're doing social media posts for the same design. I'm gonna show you exactly how to use that as well. So let's get into Kittl and get into Infinite Canvas. All right, so here we are on Kittl, kittl.com. Now, if you came to this page right away, you probably see a pop-up talking about Infinite Canvas. I just turned it off just because I didn't want it to be distracting, but I'll show you exactly how to use it. So first thing you want to do is start a new project. So go here, and it's going to start the same way as it did before with your settings. So you choose an artboard. You could either choose these pod presets. I usually like choosing 4500 by 5400, so I'm going to create that. And you can see it's right here, but we can kind of zoom out so you can see it. And you're gonna notice right away two things. This up here, create multiple artboards, right? You can try it now. And this right here, the new setting. So I'm gonna say try it right now, and it's gonna kind of take you through a tutorial. So let's see. No, maybe not. Maybe we're just gonna do it right here. So the two things right here is move. So I'm gonna do move. And you notice when you move, you can move the artboards anywhere you want. Oh, here we go. Artboard settings, great. Part of the tutorial, you can change the settings for your artboards here. Okay, let's show them how to do that. So, oh, and that popped up too. So maybe we'll see that later. So on this side, when you have the artboard selected, you can change the artboard size really quickly, some of the presets that we already have. So if you didn't like 4,500 by 5,400, you can just click this and boom, right there. Or you can come down here and look for some of the other pages, right? So you got your Facebook post, you got, oh, I guess that's the same thing. You got a postcard, like really quick right away, right? Boom. Now I wish they did put some of the other stuff in here, like my print on demand stuff. Maybe they're working on it. But you can also, if it's not the right size, you can change it right here and go, I would go pixels, you can see here, and then 4,500 by 5,400 again. Can change it. Boom. And so now it's back 4,500 by 5,400. Clip content. So if you have something, what that means is let's grab some elements here. Just anyone will do. I'm going to take this banner. So you can see it's clipping the content inside the artboard. If I turn this off, click the artboard, you can see it shows it, doesn't show it. That's clip content. I'll take that off. And let's see, what's the other one? Oh, background color, just like you do, you can just click background color. And so if you want it on a black t-shirt, for example, or a white t-shirt, you can do that. And obviously opacity for that color. All right, so the next thing is this artboard. So there's shortcuts here. You can see move is V, artboard is A. So if I can click on A to switch between, you can see it's highlighted here and this one's highlighted. That's how you know which one you're on. See the that color inside the icon. So on artboard, what you do, you can see this little crosshairs is I can come in here and I can draw another artboard. Now I can make it the same thing. I can make it the right size here. Boom, I can change it to 5,400 by 4,500 by 5,400 here, right? But if you already know that you like this size, you could also just click on here, hold down option or start, I think, and then just drag it, boom. So you're copying just like you would something else, like if you had one of these down here, same thing, option and drag, same thing, option, drag artboards as well. You can also delete artboards. So if you didn't want this one, you can just click on it and delete, and you can copy and paste artboard. So if I came in here and I did Command C and I just hit Command V, you can see it made a new artboard with exactly the same thing in here. Now this can come in handy if you're doing scale designs or you want to do another design but in a different color, you can just copy. You don't have to do the whole thing all over again. You can just copy it, and I'll show you that in a little bit. Another thing, let's see, I think we got everything. So move, artboard, so let's put this into action here. I'm gonna delete this. I'm gonna actually go to my templates. So this is how I would use it. Or actually my projects, let's do that instead. So these are all the things that I've done recently. So let's do this iguana rock one here, boom. So now with this, I'm gonna zoom out. Oh, zooming out, let's see. You can click this minus button like this. And oh, for moving, one other tip is to hit the space bar. You see this hand, I can move my artboards around like that. So let's move it over here. I'm gonna click on this artboard, right? And then hit, I'm gonna hold down option and drag. So there you go. I have two of them now. Both of them have iguana rock. So let's go on here. I have the background color set to white. I can make it black, but now I can't see these letters. So maybe I'll make it just a little less black so I can see it there. And now I can change these to white. And so I'm working on a shirt that looks like it would be a black shirt. So I'm gonna have to zoom in. I'm holding down option and my scroll wheel to zoom in, but you could zoom in with this as well. And I'm gonna click everything that was black to white, but you could do that here with your project color. So I'm gonna move here and I'm gonna pick everything that was black here in my project to white, boom. And now I can do this. Change my background color, whoops, to black. And I'm gonna zoom out again. Oh, it picked all my artboards, dang it. Okay, because the whole thing's the project. I was supposed to only pick the artboard color, not the project color. That's okay. I'm gonna pick white, black, and so on. Oh, and one right here. And one way to make sure that you got all of them is I'm gonna change my background from white to something else. Yeah, I think I got it. Cool. All right, so this is how I'd use two artboards. You got one on a white t-shirt and one on a black t-shirt. And you'll notice that in the layers, there's these two. So you got artboard one and artboard two, so you can see which one you're looking at, and you can change the name too. So if you want to say black, black shirt, right? And you can go white shirt. Cool. And we need to save that. So the project, you got the project name. Actually, don't want the copy. There we go. Wanna rock, white shirt, black shirt. Now, another thing I would do is actually make an Instagram post. So I'm gonna come in here, do this, make my thing like that, custom size, Instagram post, right? Boom. So one thing I wanna do for the Instagram post is do a mock-up. Let's see how this would work. So I'm gonna use this for my mock-up. And let me move this here. Maybe do this. Okay, now that I got this here, I'm gonna download my mockup. Boom. All right, and then I'm gonna go back to my editor and I'm gonna put my mockup here. So, there we go. And then I can have it here, and I'm gonna zoom in here, and this can be my mock-up. So I can put my mock-up, my Instagram posts, all of that in here. And I wonder if there are Instagram posts. Did somebody actually make one? I'm gonna see if somebody did make one. Let's see. Templates, t-shirts, logos, posters, thumbnail, social. Nice. Okay, promotional, inspirational events, promotional. Let's see what they got. Oh, cool. So here's some things right here that I could use. So I found this one right here. I'm gonna add this to my current so you can see I can add a template to my thing here. And I probably should have done this first. And you can see, I'm gonna zoom in. I could do this as my mockup. And this one I think is a already a mockup here. So could do that, or I could move this out and move this guy in here and move it to the background. And you know, come have some of this stuff in here. Whoops, and move these things around. So any way you want to do it, I didn't do a mock-up really good here, but you can see I can use this for different things. So I can have my white shirt, my black shirt, my social media posts, any of the promotional stuff, everything related to my design here, all on one artboard. And I think that's incredible. You can do, you know, make stuff for different things as well. So if you want your phone case design here, mock that up. If you want your tote bag, your sticker, it can all be on one thing and you can just call this your design. And I think that's how I'm going to use it going forward. If I create t-shirts here, I can create the stickers here, I can create my social media posts here, all with in one project right here. So I think that's really cool. And remember, you can organize your projects in your layers panel too. So right here, black shirt, white shirt, and we can call this social media, right? And then you can do another one for phone case and so on. So very, very powerful. I think this can help going forward. And if, and this can also work for scale designs if you're doing scale designs for Amazon. Let me show you an example of that. All right, so here's a design I made a long time ago for Christmas. You can see the hiking elf. But if I wanted to make scale designs, I can come in here, move this artboard here, and then hold down option and just do a bunch of them, right? And instead of hiking elf, I can do the cooking elf or the playful elf or the hungry elf. I don't know, whatever you want, right? And of course, you gotta stretch this to make it fit. But you can see very easily, I can take a design like this. Now, don't go doing all these elf ones, but come up with your own, figure out one that you can scale. Now, scaling designs only really work on Amazon and Etsy. You can't really do this with the new categories and tiers on Redbubble and TeePublic. But if you are on Amazon or if you are on some of those other pod sites that don't mind scale designs, you can see how quickly this is to do this on here, just because you're just changing one word and you have all the design. So another great reason to have multiple artboards on one project, scale designs, and so on. So hopefully this was really helpful for you, and now you can play with it. I believe everybody has it. And you know, I think this will really change the game on Kittl. So there you go, that's Infinite Canvas on Kittl. Again, multiple artboards, and I think this is just a game changer. You can organize your designs a whole lot better. You can do your design for, you know, scale designs, for multiple colors, for multiple products on here, just all organized in one way. And I think this can help you speed up your design and actually think about all these things together instead of just thinking about the one design. You can think about all and how these things are connected. So Kittl's just getting better and better. They keep improving, which is awesome. If you want to learn more about Kittl, I have a whole playlist of Kittl right here. I'll put it right here. And if you haven't tried Kittl yet, and if you want to try it, I'll put a link to Kittl on here. It's an affiliate link, but it's a way that you can start and try it. I believe it's free for 30 days or something like that. Try it out. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.